ATP synthesis through chemi osmosis. Chemi osmotic hypothesis proposed by scientist Mitchell. In this hypothesis, ATP synthesis is carried out. In PS2 and PS1, the electron transportation is carried out among the electron oxidants, and also the proton translocation is taken into the lumen. The protons are accumulated more in the lumen. That happened why? Because here at stroma, the water molecule, the protons are transmitted from stroma to lumen through the quinone cycle. Through quinone cycle, the available protons, they are entered into the lumen. Here, the concentration of protons are increasing, as well as during the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, the water molecule splitting is happened. On that condition, from one water molecule, two electrons and two protons are released. The electrons are being carried among the electron carriers, but the protons are accumulated in the lumen. You see here, from stroma also to lumen, they are entered through the quinone cycle. And in the time of water splitting also, the protons are released. The protons, released protons, are inside of the lumen only. It means here the concentration of the protons are increasing. And in the stroma, during the non-cyclic photophosphorylation, FADH2 is produced. Where the FADH2 is produced? FAD is produced very near to the thylakoid membrane at the side of the stroma. Here, by using of the H+ ions, NADP is reduced as NADPH. It means the reduction of NADPH conducted by taking of protons. Then that leads to the reduction number of protons. The number of protons are get reduced in the stroma. So here the pull is maintained. It means protons pool is maintaining inside of the lumen. But in stroma, the number of protons rate is decreased. Here, inside of the lumen, the pH is increasing. So the pH is increased means here that indicates the number of protons are accumulated inside of the lumen. But they do not transmit it from lumen to stroma. Why? Because here the thylakoid membrane is present. Between these two, the thylakoid membrane work as an impermeable membrane. It is impermeable to the protons entry from lumen to stroma. It inhibits the entry of the protons from lumen to stroma. So there is a need of another entry. The entry, the proton channel, the proton pathway, that is created by one factor, that is coupling factor. So you are seeing here, that is the coupling factor. The factor can have the two particles, two parts. One is F0 and another one is F1. So to pump the protons from lumen to stroma, the F0 is worked as a proton channel. Through this channel, the protons are entered into the stroma. While they are entering into the stroma, here when they are fallen onto the F1 particle, the F1 particle is worked as a rotatory particles. So it is one of the minute, smallest rotatory particle in the world. While its rotation, it releases some force. The force is taken by ATPH enzyme that promotes the ATPH enzyme activation. Here the ATP synthase is activated because of protons jump. Okay, so the ATP synthase is activated means the ADP and PA is being converted into ATP. Here you see here the proton pump is work out against the proton gradient. And then for three protons pumping, one ATP is released. One ATP is resulted. For three protons pumping, one ATP is released. So the number of protons are based on the number of water molecule splitting. If two number of water molecules are splitted means how many protons are accumulated inside of the lumen. So for one electron, two protons. But here if two molecules of water means four protons are accumulated inside. For protons means how many ATPs are formed? One ATP is formed. Like based on the protons accumulation, based on the proton number, the ATP formation is depends. So this is completely explained in chemi osmotic theory by scientist Mitchell. It the same procedure happened in electron transportation of mitochondria, oxidative phosphorylation of mitochondria. There the proton can pump from inner membrane space to matrix of mitochondria. In two cases, one at mitochondria, another one at chloroplast, in two cases ATP is generated through the chemi osmotic hypothesis. And in the light phase, photophosphorylation is carried out. Two photophosphorylations, cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation. So that yields to oxygen release and production of assimilation energy. Production of assimilation energy. What is assimilation energy? Assimilation energy is the energy released in light reaction in the form of ATP and NADPH. So these two are called as assimilation energy. They are produced in light reactions. The released assimilation energy is utilized in biosynthetic phase. So what is biosynthetic phase? At dark reactions, the carbohydrates are synthesized. Here the carbon assimilation also carried out. The carbon dioxide is reduced as carbohydrates. So the stage is called biosynthetic phase. For carbohydrates preparation, the assimilation energy is utilized.